The West African nation of Ghana will seek support from the International Monetary Fund after his currency, the cedi, collapsed 40% this year. To discuss the implications of this rescue, with me is Stephen Bailey-Smith of Standard Bank. Mr. Bailey-Smith, thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Ghana is the second country in Africa so far this year who has gone to the International Monetary Fund for help. Could you tell us how we reached this situation?
Ghana had been progressing very nicely. It had been one of the darlings, if you will, on the African continent. It had undertaken a number of reforms and had been growing very swiftly. In many ways, that growth outpaced its ability to finance that growth. So the economy overheated, as demonstrated by the twin deficits. And in the last couple of years, since the last elections, the government's been attempting to rein in that growth and rein in the twin deficits, and has been struggling to do that, and to a certain degree has lost the confidence of the markets. So I see this move to rekindle relationships with the IMF very much as a way of rebuilding confidence, investor confidence, in their ability to deliver sustainable growth in the future.
What was the main problem with the fiscal deficit? Because one of the factors has been a big increase in salaries on the public sector.
Yes, so they had a program which they call the single spine sort of program, which basically renegotiated all of the salary structures across the public sector. This is actually something that this government inherited from the previous government. The implementation of that, however, has created huge kind of wage increases. Wages are, I think, now something like 60% of total expenditure, which is clearly unsustainable longer term. So in many ways, they need to deflate that back out of the system.
And how is going to be that negotiation with the IMF? Because when the technocrats of the IMF arrive into Accra, the capital of Ghana, one of the first things they're going to start to question is, we need cuts, and that's going to be politically very painful for the government.
To a certain extent, Ghana had wished to implement its own sort of homegrown reform process. So a number of the heavy lifting sort of programs have already started. So they had negotiated a wage freeze and an employment freeze. They've jacked up VAT. They removed subsidies on fuel, although that crept back in a little bit. They removed a huge amount of subsidies on electricity and water. We should remember that the finance minister, Seth Turkpa, worked at the IMF as a fiscal consultant for 10 years. So he's very well aware of the sort of measures that will be implemented.
What is, because timing is going to be very important for the market, how has been so far the market reaction?
So the market's taken it very well. I think in many ways the market saw it as a bit of a free option. If the government signs up to an IMF deal, it means that they're willing to do the right thing and willing to take the austerity that's imposed on them.
And should we take Ghana as an example of other potential problems in Africa? Because for the last 10 years, we have seen a strong economic growth. Are we now beginning to see a different phase where the phase is a bit more nuanced?
I think you have to understand the meta-narrative. Most of Africa is in that process of building infrastructure. So we have a huge drive to overcome the infrastructure deficit. And during that period, you have to invest a huge amount of cash and you have to borrow a huge amount of cash. So we are not in the area where deficits are likely to come down. Now, managing that process of borrowing to build the infrastructure which enables you to compete is very difficult. So we're entering that period where you will have economies that overheat and have to slow themselves down and restructure a little bit during that process to industrialise, to get over that infrastructure hurdle where they can compete internationally.
Mr. Bailey-Smith, thank you so much. And for more on Ghana, you could go to ft.com/Africa.